Force.
This week we'll be talking about a shark works, like explaining to a shadow how the dark works. Some of you know, but in case you don't, it's kind of like explaining how the heart works.
Welcome to Harris Hill Raceway in San Marcos, Texas. This is my first time on a racetrack. Been doing regular car reviews for 4 years. First time doing this. Harris Hill is an inertia track, which I am told favors driver's skill and speed management over horsepower. The owner, Bo, has a great sense of humor, which fits well with regular car reviews. The clubhouse of Harris Hill feels like a small municipal airport where right stuff pilots trade stories. It's a calm oasis from the new terror feelings for many first times that are happening out there. This was Regular Car Reviews Austin, but it all took place at Harris Hill Raceway. Being inside the clubhouse was like playing Mario Kart after getting laid for the first time because you're not sure if you did it right, and Mario Kart is familiar and known compared to the pile of strange you just got finished wrestling.
9/11 Shark Works. A pile of strange.
Why would you bother getting a GT3 RS? Why this Porsche? It's the difference between sex with a condom and blood dick. It makes all the sense in the world to be responsible, to have protection, to be safe. But then there's that draw of danger, the allure of a track-ready car that doesn't offer you stability control or driver assist from some computer that tries to do the job for you. A GT3 RS is still rear-wheel drive, like Monday nights on the USA Network. It's still a raw experience, except this one's actually entertaining. Nugget and Monica had this car since 2009 and purchased it with 4,000 miles on the odometer from a dealer in Nashville, Tennessee. Modifications began in 2011, such as a roll cage and harnesses, just to kick things off. He's owned this GT3 for 9 years and plans on driving it until it dies. Why not? When you put this much time into loving something, it almost seems crazy to let it go in a very Odo and Kiera kind of way. Here's Monica telling us about driving this car. Oh, by the way, this is terrible. This is a terrible road car. Anybody who wants to buy a Sharkworks GT3 RS and drive it on the street? This is a terrible street car. It's loud. It punches you in the gut and the spleen. This is the kind of car chiropractors dream about while they jerk off two-handed.
The kind when you alternate between working the base of the shaft and...
Driving a Sharkworks on the street turns you into a maximum twat. Mustang owners will tailgate you. Hell, any modern muscle car is like, ooh, who do you think you are? Anyway, Monica, take it away.
There is not a standard Sharkworks conversion. Okay. Sharkworks does, you know, they talk to the owners, they figure out what the owners do with the car, and then they do to the car what's appropriate for those owners.
Okay.
So we had a couple We had a couple of long conversations with them where we basically said we do HPDEs, we throw it around the track for fun. We want it to last as long as possible on the track and be fun. And they set it up for that. So they did things like the GT3 originally comes with titanium rods. And we switched those out for a very particular design of steel rods, which are heavier, but are more durable. The titanium rods, after about 60,000 miles, if you track the car, you have a risk of them bending. The steel rods will go over 120. They tucked us into the Bilstein suspension on it. It's a little bit stiffer than OEM, but not a whole lot. A two-way adjustable suspension, and the PASM no longer works. So the PASM is the self-adjusting suspension from Porsche. That's the little shock button right there. And that no longer does anything. And the suspension PASM will dynamically stiffen or soften the shocks depending on cornering loads. Okay. And we don't have that anymore. Instead, we have better tuned dampers.
Based out of Northern California, the Sharkworks team consists of Alex Sharky Ross, John Wood, James Hendry, and Dan Kennedy, and they tune the hell out of your average Porsches, and charge handsomely for the privilege, because, as the owner explains, these guys occupy a very narrow niche of Porsche tuning shops that can handle working on Metzger engines and their complex inner workings. It's not difficult to find a place that will reprogram your ECU or do alterations to a forced induction system, but the extent of these rebuilds are beyond the pay grade of a lot of your average Porsche shops. Around the time of the dot-com bubble, Alex Ross had a website dedicated to tech reviews called Sharky Extreme. It was his decision to sell the website that allowed him to fund the creation of Sharkworks as we know it today. He brought on James Hendry as his chief mechanic, owing to his decades of experience working on Porsches. There was also the bigger issue that, frankly, Hendry and Ross weren't exactly happy with the performance tuning options for Porsches in their area. So hell, might as well do it yourself, right? And as they grew, their team built their reputation as reliable mechanics and tuners. Sharkworks became the place to take your Porsche if you wanted to take your street rat racer and transform it into a track beast. And that's what this GT3 RS is.
It's dirty.
This is not a clean Porsche. It is not polished. It is made to go out there and dominate. Now, I do not belong in this car, and frankly, I didn't learn anything from driving this, because putting me in this car is like giving me a seasoned whore, and then she tells me I'm good at sex when she did all the work. No, it doesn't matter that this thing's, I can boast and say I took this thing around a track with the traction control off. Who cares? The suspension is so good, the tire's so sticky, and the car's so well balanced, I'm driving well inside of the envelope, so I just, there, I go fast now, I turn wheel, car turns really well, there. And yes, I went around Harris Hill very fast with no track experience, and the car did all the work. The thing is, this car is all motor.
Fast. Ow bump, and also, which ball hurts? I can't remember.
There's no turbo. And Porsches, because they're balanced, are well, oh, they're so lovely beneath the power band. And then I get on it, rah, and I go, ho, 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 ho. No, no, no. Among Porsche enthusiasts, Sharkworks is best known for their 3.9 and 4.1 bore and stroke rebuilds. But Sharkworks also famously re-engineered the old Zuffenhausen flat sixes and even managed a 3.6 to 3.9 liter conversion on the 997.1 GT3. And much like the kingdom where their namesake reigns, Sharkworks is all about that water-cooled life. Thanks in large part to the amount of power you can get out of water-cooled flat sixes. Their 991, 996, and 997 variants may not have offered as much in the way of gains as their turbocharged offerings, but the improvements in overall performance for those Porsches are nothing to laugh at. This is ferocious. And this thing doesn't run on 100 octane. I mean, it can, but this is made to go around the track on 93. This is a pump gas track car. I mean, when we were out on the street, we just had to drive it to the gas station, you know, and then you're that guy with his race car at the gas station starting it up and it's pop, 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 pop. You're the automotive equivalent of a guy who keeps an actual workout regimen to unlock his gains. He's not just loading up on whey protein, chicken breasts, and hammer curls and praying for the best. He keeps a notebook and maintains a schedule. Every movement and action and change is deliberate because that's how change happens. Deliberate choices. So is a Sharkworks Porsche even necessary for most of us? No. Look, I've been skiing since I was in single digits, and I can tell you that most people out, when I see them out on East Coast slopes, and now I've been on West Coast slopes, they don't need the gear that they have. They're all done up in their fancy Rajanals and everything, and I can tell by the way they're standing, those skis are doing nothing for them. I can ski circles around them with all... They belong on rentals. They belong on head skis. All gouged and ripped up. Look, that's what's gonna teach you carving control. I could hand you my really nice K2s, and you're not going to be able to change. Gear doesn't make a skier, and cars don't make drivers. Yeah, I suppose if I give you, like, 205 length K2s and give them to an intermediate, they would ski better because they have a longer ski base, like a wheelbase. They'd become smoother, but now they're going to go faster. They're going to go ski way past their skill level. And if I drove this car all day, I would start thinking I was good, you know, driving way beyond my skill level, and then the second the margin, the adhesion stops, I'm spinning like crazy, and up, dumb YouTuber. So I maintained a healthy fear of this car, but it made me feel amazing. And that's why Sharkworks exists. Now, Monica and Nugget, who are now track instructors, need a Shark Works because their skill as drivers have surpassed the stock Porsche 911, but you only get to that point after years of practice and hundreds of hours on the track. And they have no delusions about what a Shark Works Porsche is. It spends time on the trailer, and it gets to the track on a trailer. The brakes squeak because race car. Oh, and here's something I didn't know. You don't wear a five-point harness when you're driving on the street. This Shark Works has both. It has the race harness and just the three-point shoulder belt. Monica said, no, you do not want to be wearing a five-point on the street. You want to be held by a three-point. Five or six-point harness secures your torso and your pelvis, but not your neck. In a crash, on a track, that doesn't really matter because you're wearing a helmet and a Hans device as well. But on the street, your head's just flopping around loose. So what would happen is your torso and everything would stay put, but your head and neck would just be wrenched around. It's much better on the street to be wearing a traditional three-point harness and to be protected by an airbag as well. Plus, you need to move your head to move. And to move your head and head check in traffic, your shoulders have to move along with your head. When you're all cinched down in a six-point harness here, you can't move your head and check.
Oh, sure, you're going to be the guy who just puts a bunch of mirrors inside his car.
Great. I'll see you when you're in your neck brace. Unless you're in an Ariel Atom or some car without rollover protection, you know, like an open car, you should be wearing a regular seatbelt. Yeah, Hellcat may be faster, but this is the fastest all-around car I've ever been in. Afterwards, they said, hey, you want us to take you out? Give you a real lap? And I'm like, no! I want to learn how a regular car exists on the track. So, up comes Steph Schrader. Here we go. A regular car on a racetrack. Next week, Lancer time.
Baby, let me be your boyfriend, and I'll get you...
You know what? I'm interrupting the song here. I feel I'm not being kind to a GT3 RS Sharkworks Edition 3.9 liter. It was a treat just to crawl under this car and look at all the stuff underneath. I could appreciate this car for its practical beauty. It's no longer comfortable on the road. This is only made to race now. For someone who just wants to write a check and go racing after they put in their time in an MX-5, this may not be a bad choice. After all, Sharkworks don't just build a Sharkworks edition. They will work with you. They will work with the driver. And this isn't a plug for Sharkworks or anything. I think it's good that there are companies out there who will tailor a car to a specific type of racing. And it was an honor just to be able to plod this thing around a track. You ever want to feel another guy's muscles? Awkward. That was what this was like. You see the big guy at the gym, and you just wonder, what would it be like if you just put both of your hands on his bicep and ask him to flex? You know, what would that be like? Sharkworks.
Baby, let me be your boyfriend, and I'll get you in a Sharkworks. Don't know much about chemistry, but I'll show you how a spark works. I promise that I'll buy you diamond jewels and fancy heels as soon as I'm done paying off these four wheels. Let me get you in a Sharkworks.